isometric view, front view and top view for an object are given, and we are going to construct isometric view for the given orthographic views. First of all, we have to find total length, total width and total height. Total length is 100 mm which is available in top view. Total width, again it is available in top view, 50 mm. And total height, which is available in front view, 50 mm. First of all, we will give the directions for length, width and height. This is the height direction. First of all, draw a horizontal line. Take a point on it as a origin. Draw two lines at 30 degree angle. See, here the entire object has occupied the space available to the right of origin. That's why we are supposed to take length to the right of origin. Total length is 100 mm. If right side is the length, then left side should be width. Take width to the left of origin. This is the length direction. And this is the width direction. Length, width. Height is always along vertical line. Therefore, draw vertical line passing through origin. 50 mm is the height. Draw two more vertical lines. Then set drafter to the length. Draw line parallel to length. Then set drafter to the width. Draw line parallel to width. Draw one more line parallel to width. Then set drafter parallel to length. Then lastly, draw line parallel to length. In this way, we have constructed a box having total length, total width and total height. Inside this box, we are going to put all the details for an object. Let us mark all vertical lines in front view by letter H, because all these vertical lines will be parallel to height. Then all horizontal lines should be marked by letter L for our convenience, because all these horizontal lines will be parallel to length. In the top view also, all horizontal lines will be parallel to length. Again, mark these lines by letter L. The web line is missing. Let's draw that web line. See, this line is not parallel to length, width or height, and therefore this is non-isometric line. NIL, non-isometric line. Now these two lines are horizontal lines in top view. These are also non-isometric lines, because these lines are the projections of non-isometric line in top view. Let us draw the locate this point first. It is at 20 mm from the bottom. To locate this point, we have to go parallel to height by 20 mm. Set drafter parallel to height, then locate point at 20 mm distance. After locating this point, if I want to draw this line, I should go parallel to length. Set drafter parallel to length, then draw line parallel to length. Now let us try to locate this point. This point is at 30 mm from the left end. Therefore, locate point at 30 mm from the left end. Now, if we want to draw this line, we should go parallel to height. Set drafter parallel to height. And then draw line parallel to height. Now I want to draw this line, which is vertical in top view. It should go parallel to width. all vertical lines in top view. We are marking by W, letter W, because these will go parallel to width. Let us use color coding, green color for length lines. Red color for height lines and blue color for width lines. That is parallel to length, height and width. All these lines are isometric lines because these are parallel to principal axis, that is isometric axis. Now set drafter parallel to width, then draw line parallel to width. We are drawing this line parallel to width. And to draw this line, go parallel to width from this point by 50 mm, that is total width. To draw this line, go parallel to length. Now let us draw this semicircle, isometric of semicircle, that is semi ellipse, in the top face. For our convenience, let us draw the full circle and let's circumscribe this circle in a rhombus, in a square. This square is formed by four sides, the two sides of which are parallel to width and remaining two sides are parallel to length. Therefore, mark corresponding lines width and length. Two lines parallel to width, two lines parallel to length. Color coding. For length, green line, green color. For width, blue color. For height, red color. Now let us draw this orthographic of square, which is rhombus in top face. For that, first locate midpoint. Then draw center line now with 15 mm radius and center as midpoint or center point. Mark four points on both sides in the length and width direction. Then draw two lines parallel to length through marked points. And two lines parallel to width In this way we get rhombus for square in isometric. Two lines parallel to length, two lines parallel to width. Then by using four center method, let us draw an ellipse. First draw longer diagonal, corner with midpoint. We use two centers for drawing semi-ellipse, this center and this center. Using this center and radius equal to this much, draw an arc then with another center draw a small arc using appropriate radius. Now there should be two vertical lines. Parallel to height. Now we have drawn semi-ellipse in top face. There will be one more semi-ellipse at the bottom face. We need not to draw separate rhombus for that semi-ellipse. The other option is just we can shift the used center in the height direction by 50 mm. Because distance between top face and bottom face is equal to 50 mm. We are supposed to shift that center by distance between two planes. Shift this center by 50 mm. Using old radius and new center, that is shifted center, draw an arc. Shifting center of another arc is not required because that arc is not visible in this isometric view. In isometric view, we draw just visible lines. We don't draw any invisible lines. Now let's draw the web portion. For that, locate midpoint first on this line and just extend that previously drawn center line. Then locate midpoint of this line also. Then join these two midpoints, which will be the center line for rib. Now mark two points on either side, 5 mm each, such that the total distance between two lines is 10 mm. Set drafter to this line, which is non-isometric line. Then draw two lines passing through these marked points. There should be one more line parallel to length. Let's draw that line. It is the intersection between rib and the base of an object. Now major portion has been drawn. Now let's draw this portion. Now angles given are 45 degree. We cannot transfer these angles as it is, because the line which is originally horizontal, that is with 0 degree angle, it becomes 30 degree in isometric view, and the lines which are 45 degree now, which will be reflected in isometric view with some another angle, it will not be 45 degree angle. Therefore we have to draw partial orthographic of this part. This is a dotted slot. Draw 30 mm line. Draw this line at 10 mm distance. Then draw two lines at 45 degree angle. Now mark all these four points in isometric view. These are the vertices of trapezium. We are interested in finding this distance x. Because of symmetry of object, we will get same distance here also x. Let us transfer these two distances in the isometric view. First let us locate the point at 20 mm. Then from that point again let us locate another point at 30 mm, that is in total at 50 mm from right end. Then draw this line parallel to length at 10 mm. Then draw vertical lines through these two points. Then transfer these two distances x on either side in isometric view. Using compass or divider, then join the points . See you can see here the one angle has been reduced and other angle has been enlarged. during the transformation of orthographic view into isometric view. That's why we cannot transfer angles as it is from orthographic view into isometric view. We have to go for some orthographic partial construction. In this way, the total object has been constructed. Just go for finishing. Draw all object lines as thick continuous lines. At the end, you can give overall dimensions as well. We can give direction of observer. This is the direction of observer, front view direction. Small error. This is not our point, it was mistakenly taken. This is our point. Draw a line parallel to length.